today is my day off. So I want to take you guys on a traditional day off and show you what I do usually on my days off. I've got some tennis lined up with Jonni. Some of you know Jonni from previous vlogs. And then after that, I'm going to be going for raids. And I'm going to try and do as many raids as possible today in preparation for that Mewtwo. And also, I'll be trying to level up. Do you think I'll make it? I think I will. But I'll keep it a secret. Also, just a quick announcement, guys. I'm realizing that, you know, making these vlogs and for you guys not to be able to see the screen on which I actually play is really weird and perhaps not enjoyable. I still really enjoy making these videos because I hope you guys still enjoy to see me and just my days in general. But I also do understand that, you know, competitively it's not really helping me, considering that all other YouTubers, you know, have screen recorders on their phones. The fact is I'm running on an iPhone, as you know. And oh, by the way, I've managed to fix my screen finally, so it is like brand new. I've also put a brand new battery inside it. It cost me £25, which is half the price you usually cost. Because I was getting the screen fixed, they gave me that discount. So I do have quite a fresh iPhone to use at the moment, but as a lot of you know, iPhones don't have that software, the ability, the capacity to have screen recording software on them. I don't know the details why, I'm not an expert, but what I've been thinking of doing is buying a phone on which I can, I've been thinking about this anyway before I started the vlog, but it would really help to have another phone on which I'll be able to just only play Pokemon Go, also for the battery purpose, so that phone will just be the phone I use specifically to play Pokemon Go. And so, you know, like, even if the battery does get rinsed out on there, it will be like a Samsung basically. I could just buy replacement batteries. My cheapest replaced batteries are on Samsung then, on iPhones anyway. So yeah, that's the plan. And so next time you see a video, it'll probably have the little screen on the side on which you'll be able to see exactly where I'm going, what's spawning, and I'll be able to actually commentate properly there. And then serious vlogging will start. So this might be the last video of this. I do hope you still enjoy it. It's gonna be a fun day ahead. And I will also be kind of wrapping up the video at the end to explain to you guys what you missed out on, if there is anything you should miss out on. So I hope you enjoy the rest of it. Thank you. Game, set, match point. The battery's about to run out, boys. I'll chat to you guys later. That was it, guys. It was an amazing day, as you saw. I'm sorry there wasn't much commentating on it, but especially during the raids, I kind of have an issue where I feel like I'm not famous enough as a YouTuber to kind of just say, hey, you know, here's my camera, you know, and everyone just be like, hey. But at the same time, I don't really want to be kind of like that creep that's just kind of like, you know, recording people and everyone's kind of like, what? And there's actually been a few occasions where people have just been kind of like looking and thinking like, what's going on here? And some people have just asked me to record and I'll just say to them, yeah, you know, I'm doing YouTube videos and, you know, check it out if you want. So, yeah, but I'd rather kind of not record people's faces for the time being, and just to avoid the whole kind of mess of, you know, taking me out of your video or whatever. If you're recording their feet and their legs, I think it's usually legally not binding, because it could be anybody's legs. You know, it's you know, it's really hard to put a case on someone for recording their legs. You know, so and it also makes for pretty decent cinematic effects. You know, just kind of seeing people's legs move about and everybody kind of standing together. So I feel like it's the easier way to kind of go about it. And also, I was going to say another thing. Update you on what happened. So we done 3 raids. I know that doesn't sound like a lot, but believe me, walking around all over the place in a big city like London, it does take quite some time, you know, kind of trying to organize with different people. And someone will be like, oh, you know, I've got 3 people coming, can we wait for them? And everyone's like, okay, let's wait for them. And you know, so it, you know, it's a fun process, but you know, it does take the time. So I actually got home at 4. I was planning to be done with everything, including the tennis session, by 2. So that kind of gives you an idea of, you know, how time draining city life is. But yeah, I did catch me an Articuno and a Moltres. I missed out on the Lugias. Lugias are really hard. I'm finding them really hard to catch. I don't know if you guys are having the same issues. Please comment down below, let me know. Even though the circle for the Lugia when you try and throw the ball is really big, I think the catch rate is much lower. Somebody in the raid, during the raid, was mentioning that even with a great ball and a raspberry and a curveball, the catch ratio is still only 15%. I just realized that this is not on my face. That was disappointing, because I was looking to get another Lugia. I've only got one Lugia, and I only got one Moltres as well, but I just want more Lugias. Lugias, you know, he's a legendary, you know. There is something about the legendary birds, you know, we they are known as legendary birds, but you know, they don't have that legendary feel that, you know, Lugia and Mewtwo have, you know. So yeah, I will be going out later this week or early next week to try and catch a Lugia. I think next time I go raiding, it'll probably just be only exclusively for Lugias, because I've only got one and it's not a good IV one. At the moment, I'm now fully set with other Pokemon. Like, I've got a 90% and above IV copy of each of the birds. So I just need another Lugia, hopefully a really good IV one. And hopefully that would have been it. In total, I've done over 20 raids in the last 2 weeks. With the ones I'll do next week, it would probably approach, by the time Mewtwo comes, I'll probably have done about 25 raids in total, because I'm looking to keep doing the kind of, you know, the standard one raid a day that you get for free. But I will also probably be buying a few more raid passes and doing an extra few the days before Mewtwo comes, just to kind of make sure that I'm hitting all the spots that, and you know, the Pokemon Go hub has given about, you know, the requirements to be part of these exclusive raids for Mew, which aren't clear, but it's just classic, you know, Pokemon Go news. It's never really too clear. I don't know if it's part of their, you know, strategy, or if it's just them not having the resources to make, you know, accurate news. But it does seem as though you do have to do not only a lot of raids, but you also have to do them in a lot of different locations. So that will unfortunately mean, for rural players, they will probably have to travel around in nearby towns to make sure they have as many chances as possible. For me, it's not too much of an issue, obviously, because I'm living right in the center of London. But at this moment, I mean, I'm with you, my thoughts, if you're a rural player. That being said, good luck. If I do not upload before Mewtwo comes out, then yeah, this will be my good luck wish to everybody. May the best players get their Mewtwo, and everyone else, don't be salty, but don't be too salty. That's it for me, guys. Thank you, bye.